just kept hearing it. I'm ducking and everything. God, in the house, I got scared. I dropped my hot pocket.
Can I ask you, if you want all the money, what would you do with it?
Bunch of hookers and cocaine.
Please give me no answer. That's probably not the answer that we're looking for.
Well, the sign says that it's four quarters for an hour, but a quarter only gets you 15 minutes. So if my math is correct, that's not an hour.
And also my mom thinks I'm a baby, so I can't walk to school sometimes. And also she thinks I need protective gear when I need to ride a bike.
You probably do. I think I agree with you.
I know how to ride a bike already, even without protective gear.
Did you really snatch an 86-year-old woman's purse?
She wants to hurt me.
Why is she so mad?
She don't even know me. I hope that they beat that, some of the women in prison beat that every day for as long as she's in there.
Some people might say that's harsh.
Well, so what she did to me was even worse.
It was even worse.
I'm sorry for that. I don't.
I don't want to get out of my house. So when I pulled the gun out on him, I guess he didn't think it was a real gun because he didn't worry about it. He just kept on walking. When he was coming down the stairs and told me he was going to kill me and F you all that, I shot through a hamper that he was carrying. It was a full metal jacket bullet. I went straight through the bag of him and was like, and he started crying like a little baby.
Charles, why did you come so early this morning, man?
Well, the reason why I come so early to celebrate Martin Luther King's birthday, because I feel it's really good to come, because, you know, Martin Luther King's birthday comes on January, I would say it's important to always come and celebrate the great Martin Luther King's birthday, because it's really important. It's good.
Fuck no, baby!
And she said, hey, something wrong, it's popping. I said, what? She said, yeah. I said, no. So the girl come downstairs, she come out of her apartment with her baby with no shoes on. I said, oh, girl, it's cold out there. She said, something ain't right. I said, oh, man. She said, oh, man, the building is on fire. I said, no, what? I got my three kids and we bounced out. We ain't gonna be in no fire. Not today.
Please tell us what happened.
What the hell? I'm in the room, chilling, kicking like I usually do, drinking, and somebody shot right through my back window, hit me in the chest. And I'm like, shit, get my son out the room. You know, I wasn't even tripping over it. It's like a little petty wound, you know? I ain't even tripping, though.
Absolutely. So you did show me on your chest where you were shot. Are we able to see that right now? Or? What do we know what happened? Do you know who? Do you know why they would have done this?
I don't know what's going on, man. I just know niggas probably just want me dead.
By the way, this is
this stuff. I don't know.
All right. Well, I'm here. And what's your name?
Devon.
All right, well, I just talked to Devon, and I can't believe all that just happened.
Well, I just have got done feeding my chickens, watering them.
It's unfair.
I walked back to my house there to get my phone so I could play a video game on it. And all of a sudden, I heard a big boom. I looked back out the door, and the electric pole fell, and the lines were falling. And the geotracker was sideways into the fence. And there was a guy come out screaming and squalling.
Hey, easy.
And running around. About like the chicken with head cut off. I told him he needed to get out of that water, but say I didn't know he was getting eaten up by bees. I thought he was just hot. That girl in that little bikini, she had a little red dot.
I may be very
fucked up.
I say about the day they are. If I feel like my leg feels, that's the thing.
I don't think you can sit in my bed. It might break.
We had a few audience there in the first period, which was not good for us, but I mean, everyone had their nerves going and everything like that, and then. Which we were glad to just keep him to one and everything like that. And then we went back in the, after the period in the locker room, just talked about what we need to fix and everything like that. Stick to the game plan. Get back on it and everything like that. So just paid off, stick to the game plan, you know, stepping up defense and everything like that. No pinches, everything like that.
You moving on to the semifinals. And your uncle, Stu, played here a while back, I think 20 years ago with Alexandria. Did you get any advice from him coming in here to the tournament?
Yeah, I got a nice long text from him this morning saying don't let the atmosphere, you know, get your nerves shaken up and everything like that. Just play your game, which is what I try to do out here and everything like that. So
No, everything you know, like that's like, you know what I'm saying?
That's the same. I hate that. Mommy.
Mommy. I can't wait to play him. I know they're.
And then I went down and saw Mommy. And I saw that beat, Mommy.
You say you're a little tired this morning. Is that right?
I am tired.
She is very tired. That's actually, I heard, your favorite activity to do at the center here is to take a little nap.
That's a long time.
You can nap many times.
Oh, she's adorable.
You sound like a very busy lady.
Why are you fucking with her?
Yes. Later today, Fosse's family is going to be coming out here to throw you a big birthday party. Are you excited for your party?
Yeah, when you get 110, you can say whatever you want
to
say.
Fosse, the people on TV want to know what the secret is to being able to live so long.
When is Al coming back, if it is?
I don't know. I don't fight it. I live it.
She doesn't fight it. She lives it. Any secret food or anything we can all be eating every day to stay alive as long as you?
No.
I heard a big boy say, with that woman? I said, what in the world is that? So I was finna get out. He said, no, you ain't need something. I said, what is that? Al? He said, that's a tornado. So he let the windows up and held me down in the seat. And I was like, Jesus. It was down and it went waiting to stick right the sausage over my bed. Thank you, Lord. That's what happened.
Thank you, Lord.
Right over my head.
I can't even imagine the feelings you guys must have been going through. You actually helped her get her down, right, Alan?
Yeah.
As far as I know,
have you guys ever been through a tornado before?
I've never
seen
one in my life.
When you look around at all the damage, I mean, what kind of damage have you guys seen?
It was just, it stuck flying in the air. I guess what it done took up here. It was flying out in the air. So it went
all in the air.
Behind the slaughterhouse. Then it went upward, then it come back down. And then it went all around.
When you look down at yourselves and you see that you're okay, what goes through your mind seeing that you're all right?
That God had an angel over us. And that's what I see. God is good. Because that band, it chipped it a little bit. And that tornado just went over that van. Because it came straight to us. And when I said, Jesus, that tornado went up over
me. Oh, well, I tried something Saturday night. You've just crashed into the shop. Oh, he goes, oh, mate, I fell asleep behind the wheel. And I'm like, yeah, righto, mate. Well, you still don't be fleeing the scene. And he goes, don't be a hero, mate. I wasn't trying to be a hero. I was just chasing down the street and he was supposed to stop.
You ran down the street in your jumps.
Yeah, in me undies, yeah, correct. Chasing down the street in me undies and then he started getting too far and I'm like, oh, well, I better catch up to him. Yeah, come back home and drop your car. And started chasing down the street in a little purple car.
Well, there you go, a possible career in law enforcement. How are you, Daniel?
Yeah, well, it's fun, isn't it?
Now, I'm not going to ask you if you've committed any crimes, but are you expecting a reward for your amazing neighbourhood watch work here this morning?
Yeah, handshake from me, mate, and I got it this morning.
And Daniel has just become the local neighbourhood hero here.
Oh, sign that man up.
Neighbourhood watch, that guy needs his own show.
He doesn't. That's what I mean. Sign him up. That's one of your best interviews ever, Michelle.
Back in Sydney. Yeah. Would you like your own show?
If I'm going to be with Koshy, I will.
There you go, Koshy. And you